Good evening, everybody. So I want to start from thanking God for giving this wonderful evening to all of us. Thank you, Manage, for giving this particular platform. And thank you, Shiva Prasad, sir, for giving us this opportunity. And thank you all Manageites, those who are present over here, to listen us.
Sure.
We are going to present our business plan of funds chips. Okay. So let us look and meet the team. So first, we have friendly Fawaz A. Sheikh, who's leading as head HR, and he will be leading our HR team. Second is me, Ultimate Utsav Pavendra, who would be
Wow.
doing ultimate promotions. Third is Nifty Neetu. She will be
Wow.
handling as a director. And third is scintillating Sandhya. She
Wow.
would be taking care of sales as sales chief. Okay, now let us have a look at our market research, and I'm handling over the platform to Neetu.
Thank you, sir. So our market research was related to our business plan only, and we have come to the conclusion of what our product should be based on this market research. So you will come to know about the product later. First of all, the idea behind our market research. Actually, in most of the shops, we come across potato chips by giants like PepsiCo and Haldiram. And these kind of chips are very common and available across India. So we thought that why it is only potato chips? And that is the motto behind our market research. And we wanted to launch an alternative for potato chips so that we understand that there are many other ingredients from which we can make chips. And if it can be made available like potato, then it will be nice. Like, Utsav, can I go to the first question? So the first question we asked was frequency of chips preference, and we understood that majority of the respondents consume chips once in a week, and chips was the majority of salty snacks that was consumed by our respondents. Next. So we asked if they are willing to try any other chips other than that is made of potato. And yes, we got a hell yeah from our respondents. 81.5% of them told that they wanted to actually try other chips than potato. So that was a green signal for us to launch this product. Next, please. Okay. We asked about previous experimentation if they have tasted any other chips. And then also we got that majority of them had actually experimented their taste with chips. Please. So we asked if they have any ingredient preference in chips. So we had given certain options. Out of that, the top one was being banana. And again, some people were very reluctant to change from potato. And we got a 32.6% of only potato chips respondents. But we were very confident because we got 47.8% of them preferring to go for banana chips. Our product was actually coming out of this question only. Next, please. Okay. So, and we asked if what kind of a flavor do they prefer in chips, and most of them preferred that they would go for salt and spicy chips. So, combining the previous question and this question, we had come to the conclusion that our product would be salt and spicy banana chips as the initial starts. Next, please. And then we asked if they have any health consciousness, and we ha got a mixed response, but majority of them doesn't prefer calorie or health when it comes to snacking, and we were really confident to go about the product from this. Then we asked about the important consideration. The major consideration was flavor only. So we understood that in our B plan, we have to focus more on the flavor aspect. Rather, yes, we understood the importance of packaging and the ingredient quality of ingredient used and the brand name. But above all that, they preferred to have a good flavor of chips. So our main focus would be to preserve this flavor and present them the most. The methodology we used was survey, And we used a Google Form platform for taking the survey, which was very easy to use and accepted by many. 90% of our respondents were between the age of 18 to 25. We also find that our target customers would also be from that age group who are having a busy lifestyle and would prefer snacking. And we had 100 respondents, that is our sample size. So from this, we arrived at a conclusion what our product would be for proposing a business plan. I invite other teammates to continue.
Yeah, let's have next slide. Good evening, everyone. Here I am to give like an introduction about what we are actually doing. So as you've seen from the previous survey, that we have chosen banana. And for the flavors, we have chosen spicy and salty. But now let me actually tell you what were the other factors that went into choosing this. The first thing is that the presence of banana chips is very faint in the organized chip sector. You see that already, as said by Neetu, it is dominated by companies like Pepsi. And they really promote only potato. So we wanted to bring the banana chip, which is an indigenous snack in India, which is present everywhere. It's omnipresent. We wanted to bring it to the forefront. And that is why we chose it. Secondly, we chose cities of tier 1 and tier 2, because here the presence of the unorganized sector is very less, and so we won't have any direct competition. But the main issue with the banana existing is that there's a poor quality in packaging, and this leads to the oxidation of banana, and sometimes it has also led to cancer when people consume it like that. So our main focus is also on packaging. Lastly, banana is a very rich source of vitamin A, B, and C, and it has 20% sugar. This makes it a little bit healthier than the potato alternatives. Next slide, please. Okay, here you go. This is our vision statement. This is what we really believe in. And we believe to provide a rich experience to the consumer and emotionally engage him with our product and become the market leader in the salty snack segment. We really did this by including the stories of the farmers who we procure from. We include their stories on the cover of our packaging to emotionally engage the consumer. And we wanted to diversify chips. Here you can see there's a small signboard saying banana chips to the right, potato to the left. Come right. Next slide, please. And then here's our mission. Our mission is that we provide traditional banana chips made from natural ingredients and indigenously to the highest safety and quality standards with the best flavors that consumers will love. And we follow the principles of health, quality, richness, taste, nutrition, and consumer commitment, which we keep at the center of our whole plan. Next. Market and competition. So here we saw that 63% of the consumers like salt and spicy. This is from our data, from the survey data that we took. And the average age of the consumer is 18 to 25 years old. So it's a young adult and also a little bit teenage. You know, this is our target customers. And rupees 20 is the average expense per person. This was very integral when we had to set the price of our product. And almost 34.8% of our consumers ate chips only once a week. So we had to make sure that one time was the best experience for them. Next slide, please. And here you can look at the competition. This was mainly ruled by... My batchmate will take over this.
Okay, coming to the competition, we can see that this segment is mainly ruled by the companies like PepsiCo and ITC. And the PepsiCo is having a 50% market share. And here, these companies are mainly concentrating on the potato chips. And the competition in the banana chip segment is minimum from the organized sector. And the main rivals here to our competitions can be by the local players from the homemade players. So next slide. And coming to the pricing strategy, we will be first going with the 30 gram and 50 gram. Later we will be going with the 6500 and mega 200 pack. Packaging 200 gram packaging, and the pricing strategy will be like the price fixed at the 45% more than the input cost and the low unit cost for the consumer size packets. Next slide. And coming to the promotion, apart from the commercialized promotion, we will be having the other types like this. We will be giving discount packages where we will be providing 2 to 5% of introductory discount, so that this can help the consumers to experiment with the product. And coming to this free scheme, this will be mainly dealt with the dealers and the distributors, where we will be giving the offers like mini cotton packages for the distributors. And coming to the extra benefit allowance, here we will be giving the offers like scratch cards for more customer penetration in a, into this banana segment, banana chip segment. And coming to this production capacity analysis, the main focus here is 9 hours of work every day with efficient usage of inputs and resources with efficient delegation of labor, and also minimum ratio of natural variation in the final output, and to complete to have a complete control on cost behavior of product cost. And here we can see we will be producing annually like 1,250,000 units. Next slide. And coming to the production process, our main USP is like we will be involving locals with the help of self-help groups. We'll be procuring chips from them and packaging them in like sterile and hygienic condition. And also simultaneously, we will be doing the production process where the flowchart is like this. Like we will be going with raw material and then banana cutting, sterilizing, drying, frying, and also mixing with the flavors and then packaging. And the main focus is on packaging because there are very due to the oxidization of chips, many people like having health they are having very due to this oxidation, like people are having bad health effects on bad health effects.
Yeah.
Sorry for this. And coming to the initial requirement, capital requirement, including all the annual salaries, reserves, wages, promotional budgets, and raw material and working capital and all, we'll be having we will be requiring a capital amount of 50 crores for this executing this business plan.
5 crores.
Sorry, 5 crores.
Okay, as you have seen, our plan is very firm and we are very good to go with that particular plan, and we need a huge funding. So we had approached banks locally, and they had assured us a funding of like 50%. Our director Neetu is giving capital of 20%, and remaining 30% of the capital is given by other team members.
Okay,
so let us have a look at first year's return. So as we have seen that production was around 1,250,000 units, and the price, after multiplying the price into that, our total sales generated were 3,12,50,000 rupees. Our margin which we kept initially was 45%. So our profit would be 1,40,62,500 rupees, and the interest which we have to pay to bank for the 50% amount which we had taken is around 25 lakhs, and miscellaneous expenditures which we are calculating is around 15 lakh rupees. So after calculating all this, our first year is not going very good, but don't worry, we are in loss of around 4 crore rupees in first year, but this is only a start, my friends. Yes, we face big loss, and we will keep on stepping year on year, and we will be recovering the loss to 1.5 crores only in our second year, and we will be breaking even our investment in third year, and we will finally get profits in our fourth year, and we will make huge profits after reinvesting the sum back into our business, and we will be reaching to our goal of 5 crores in 5 years.
So like as you have all seen the start, the inception, the growth, and the execution of our company. Let me just give you a small summary. I'll go through this quickly before you get to the SWOT analysis. So there, as I've already said, I'm going to repeat, there was a need for banana chips. We really needed this in the organized sector. So we bought this in. And our products are priced for 30 grams, 15 rupees, 50 grams, 23 rupees, 65 grams, 27 rupees, 100 grams, 47 rupees, and 200 grams, 80 rupees. And then we chose the flavor that consumers really liked, and that is salt and spicy. And we focused on packaging, as that was the one thing that was missing. Next slide, please. Moreover, we have reached a production of 440 units per day and 1 crore 25 lakh units per year. And our competition was PepsiCo, Balaji Wafers, and ITC. And we have devised strategies like discount packages, free schemes, extra benefit allowances. And our initial capital requirements was only 5 crore, which, as Utsav has said, within 5 years, we could have recovered. With the income and the total income that we have aimed for nearly 50 crores within the next 4 years. The key ownership remains within us, with Neetu Chandra as a director, Sandhya Lakhawat, Utsav Pavendra, and Fawaz Ahmed Sheikh. And the planning began during our PGDM AVM course in Manage.
Wow. Fantastic. Congratulations. That's phenomenal. And it's so impactful. SWOT analysis is not necessary. Now you have told us very well. Thank you. That's an awesome job. Phenomenal. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. And we are open to doubts.
Thank you, sir. Everyone.